Meiosis is a process in which the number of chromosomes that are in a cell is cut in half to the separation of homologous chromosomes that are found in a deeply cell. Let us see what else is meiosis about. Meiosis involves two distinct divisions called meiosis 1 and 2. And by 1 and by 2, I mean they go through different processes. Let me explain myself tonight, 'cause I just need to make you know what they were about. Yeah, and this is what we all meiosis. And if it's just chromosomes dividing, this is what we all meiosis. Yeah, I know this is meiosis, the separation of chromosomes. Meiosis, yeah. Meiosis, yeah. Meiosis, yeah. I know this is meiosis, separation of chromosomes. There are four phases inside meiosis. Prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, and telophase 1. In prophase, it replicated chromosomes where it is homologue. Then they form a triad and do a crossover.
Yeah, during metaphase, they land in the center. During ana, they are cool to the end.
During telo, a new chromosome forms. Inside tokenesis forms two cells, and a meiosis 2 will take place. Prophase 2 makes the cells become visible. The next, she will just stay as they were before. However, cytokinesis does have a change. Instead of just having two new cells, we will have four haploid daughter cells. Meiosis, yeah. Meiosis, yeah. Meiosis, yeah. I know this is meiosis, the separation of chromosomes. Meiosis, yeah. Meiosis, yeah. Meiosis, yeah. I know this is meiosis, the separation of chromosomes.
Meiosis 1. This is basically like the regular mitosis. The pair of chromosomes are lined up in the center of the cell and then pull to each side. Meiosis is a bit different because there is something called crossing over that happens with the DNA. This crossing over is an exchange of genes. The genes are made up, not resulting in a perfect duplicate like mitosis. The cell divides, leaving two new cells with a pair of chromosomes each. Since this is meiosis, there is a very short interphase and division begins again. Meiosis 2. In prophase 2, the DNA that remains in the cell begins to condense and form short chromosomes. Each chromosome pair has a centromere. The centrioles also begin their journey to opposite sides of the cell. In metaphase 2, all of the chromosomes line up along the center of the cell and centrioles are in position for duplication. Anaphase 2 shows the chromosomes split and move to opposite sides of the cell. Each one splits into two pieces. They don't divide up the DNA between the new cells. They split the DNA that exists. Each daughter cell will get one half of the DNA needed to make a functioning cell. Telophase 2 shows the DNA completely pulled to the sides and the cell membrane begins to pinch. When it is all over, you are left with four haploid cells that are called gametes. The eventual purpose of the gametes will be to find other gametes with which they can combine. When they do, they will form a new organism. with